I've told Hogan this to his face, and we've had some interesting face-to-face meetings over the years. I still have respect for him for what he contributed to the business. The thing about the growth and the explosion of Hulkamania and the feeling that people had when they went to an event that he headlined. I know that I used to talk to the guys that would come down to Mid-South after leaving here or whatever. The day they got their booking sheet to see where they were scheduled for the next run, the only thing they looked for was his name, Hogan's name. And if Hogan's name was at the top of the sheet, they just looked to make sure their name was on the card. They didn't care if they were on the first match, the next to the last match, the middle. They wanted to be on Hogan's card because of what? They knew it was going to be a big house. It was going to be a sellout. Hogan beating the Iron Sheik was a launching point. And I think that every territory in the business got healthier after Hogan became the champion because it created an awareness on network TV. All of a sudden, you're on NBC. Wrestling becomes going from a regional thing where you got syndication, and now Vince McMahon and Dick Ebersole form a partnership, and they come up with this idea called the Saturday Night's Main Event. Well, I'll tell you something. As much of a genius as Ebersole is and still is as a president of NBC Sports, head of the Olympics, et cetera, we all know McMahon's track record to be amazing, the greatest promoter of all time, no matter who, no matter what. Hulk Hogan was the catalyst of that. If Hogan had not been in that position, the Saturday Night's Main Event probably would not have happened. He was so hot. He could wrestle any of us and would have done great business. So that was a launching point. I know that our territory in the Mid-South, business went up when Hogan got hot because the awareness for the product became more acute, much like you could say about the Monday Night Wars. When you had that many people watching TV, it created an awareness. And that's what every great promoter tries to do, create an awareness for their product, and Hogan launched that.
Gene, I was at the Garden the night that Backlund lost the title to the Sheik. I wasn't there a month later when Hogan beat the Sheik, but I know that before that victory, I had a small group of friends, you know, that liked to watch the wrestling live, not live, but at midnight after racing from Aqueduct. And then immediately after Hogan won the title, the group of people who would talk about wrestling in school expanded. Like, he made it, you know, I don't know if he made it acceptable, but he certainly made it, you know, exciting.